Hey guys, welcome to Protocol Orders Point. Okay, so this is the second part of our Flutter tutorial on Hive database. So in this part, we are going to perform a practical knowledge by creating a Hive database and storing data into it and reading the data that is being stored in Hive database. So let's begin. Okay, so let's go to our Android Studio. So here I have just created a Flutter project by name Hive tutorial and removed all the default code from main.dart page, the counter code that the Flutter gives while creating a new Flutter project, and added my own stateful widget by name home page. So inside home page, we have some buttons to add the data into our database. So I have just created some buttons, that is add, read, update the database, delete the data, and read all the data, and delete the complete box of our database. Okay, so I have just created this view. So these are the buttons that I have created. So let's begin with the tutorial. So first of all, let's go to pub/specification.yaml file, and under dependency section, you need to add Hive package. So just add this Hive package and Hive Flutter. Okay, so these are the two packages that we need to create database. So just add these two packages and hit this pubget button. Okay, so the package got successfully added. So let's go to main.dart page and let's import those packages. So here import hive.dart and hive.import/hive.flutter. So these are the package that we need to import, as we have just added the package over here. Okay, so as I said in my first part of our Flutter tutorial, first of all, we need to initialize the Hive. So for that, before starting your actual app, you need to initialize the Hive. So for that, in the main method over here, make this as asynchronous, and over here hive.initFlutter. Okay, and make it await. Okay, and that's it. We are good to go to use the Hive database. Okay, so now let's go to stateful widget over here. Okay, so inside here, let's create a box that is our database. So I will just name it the box as box1. Okay, so it is giving an error because we have not initialized it. So let me add a let keyword over here, null safety. Okay, so here I will just in init method, I will just call another method, that is create box. We are going to create a database. So let's create it. So inside this method, we are going to make use of box object that we have created, that is this one, and let's create a database box. So for that, hive.openbox. And here you need to name this box name. So let's give this name as database. Okay. So just make this method as asynchronous and make this as await. Till the database gets created, we need to wait. Okay. Okay. So now we have just opened a box by name database. So this database is, if we compare with our SQL database, it is similar to a table. So inside the table, as we store data in this box, we are going to store the data in Hive. Okay. So let's store the data in this box. Okay. So the box object name is box1. Okay. So let's add a data in box1 and let's check it out. box1.add. And here I will just add my name. Okay, so when I press on the add button, this data will get added into this box, that is data box, database one. Okay, so let's read this data. So to read this data, I will just press on this button, that is read button. Okay, so I will just print the data on my console. So box1.get, and here we need to pass the position where the data is being stored. Okay, so if we do add this, keep on adding to the box, so this will be index 1, this will be index 1, and this will be index 2, index 0, index 1, index 2. Okay, so we'll just read the value that is being stored in the index 1. Okay, so let's check this out. So I will just restart my app. Okay, so the app got installed. So let me press on the button, that is add button, and check if the data is got added. So you can see data got added. Okay, so now let's read the data that is in position 1, that is index position 1. Okay, so let's read it. So now you can see our data is in stored in our box. So now if I press, keep on pressing on this add button, so this data will be get added into our box in different index position. Okay, so let's check this out. So if I press on index 2, 3, okay, and refresh the app, and let's check. So I will just read it. So you can see in our index tree I have the data that is stored. Okay, so now let's read all the data that has been stored in our box. So here I have just created read all data. Okay, so I will just make use of a print statement to print all the data dot to map. Okay. Okay, so I am just printing all the data that has been stored in our box, and I am just converting it into a box, into a map, sorry. Okay, so let's refresh the app and let's check. So I will just read the button, I'll press on the read button. So you can see this is the data has been stored, and read all data. So now you can see these are the data that has been stored in our box. So here is the index, and in the form of index there this data are being shown stored. Okay, so now let's understand how to store the data in a key and value pair. So now we have just added the data randomly in any places, so I want to store this data in a key and value pair. Okay, so for that I will just remove this code. Okay, so box dot, so that is the method that is put. So let's check where it is. Okay, box dot put, and here we need to specify the key and specify the value. Okay, so let's specify the key as name and value as protocoders point, and I will just add my name also. The key is my name and my name is Rajat Palankar. Okay, so now this will store the data in a key value pair. Okay, so now to access this data in over here, I will just make use of box dot get, and over here you need to specify the key that you want to access. Okay, so let's specify the key as my name, and let's check this out. So hot refresh. So first of all I need to add the data. Okay, so add it and read the data. So you can see I have stored in this key the value that is Rajat Palankar. Okay, so now let's read this. So here you just need to specify name, box dot print, print dot get, box dot get, and here you need to specify the key. Let's check. I already added the data, so I just need to press on the read button. So now you can see there is a name, my name is Rajat, and the name that I have added is protocoders point. Okay, so this is how we store the data in our box database, Hive box database. So now you need to update this value, so you can just easily do it. So there is no separate functions to update the value, so you just need to make use of a key and update the value. Okay, so here specify the key that you want to update, and here you just update it. Okay, hot refresh. So let's check. Okay, so now my data is this, and now I will just update the value and I will just read the data. So now you can see our protocoderscoid.com got changed into this updated value. Okay, so now you want to delete the data that is in specific key. So suppose I want to delete this record, so for that I have just created a button over here. So let's implement it. So to implement it, so just add a box dot delete, and here you just specify the key that you want to delete. So I will just delete the name key. Okay, so hot refresh, and let's check. Okay, so read data. So now you can see these are the data that has been stored in the name, and now when I press on the delete button and again read it, so you can see the data got deleted and stored it as null, because we are accessing a null data when the read button is been pressed, so it is just returning null data. Okay, so now suppose you want to remove or erase this complete box, so you can just delete easily. So for that, over here, delete box. So here what you need to do is hive dot box, and here you need to specify the box name dot clear. Okay, so our box name is database one. Okay, so hot refresh. So let's check. Okay, so now our data we have in our box is, so these are the data that is been stored in our box, and we have this name key with this value. Okay, so let's delete this complete data and check. Okay, so I'm just pressing on this delete box. Okay, so it's done. So now if I read all the data, so you can see the data is empty. Okay, so now let me add a data and read it again. Okay, so now you can see our data that is added is this. Okay, so that's all for this video tutorial. Hope you got the concept of how to add data in Hive database. So please do subscribe Protocoders Point. So in the third part, I am going to continue this series. I am going to create an app that can change the theme and remember the theme that the user has selected before leaving the app. So thanks for watching. Please do subscribe Protocoders Point. Thank you.